What is going on YouTube? It is your boy Effective here, bringing you yet another Call of Duty Vanguard video. In today's video, we'll be going over all my competitive settings, graphic settings, controller settings, and also how to make your game less blurry. So for display settings, right now I just have VSync off for gameplay and menus. I have my own custom frame rate. Aspect ratio, I put it on automatic. Focus mode, I turn off. And just regular, like, whatever your display adapter is for your GPU. Now for quality, on the other hand, now this is where it gets interesting. I normally have everything off low, or on low, I should mean. That's what mainly most competitive players use anyways. You always want your render resolution to be at 100, so for like the 1080p aspect, dynamic resolution you want to turn off. I have texture resolution on low, then we have very low, low, off, low, off, long, so like you could see more detail, long range, nearby level of detail high, distant level of detail high, clutter draw distance high, and then we turn volumetric quality level low. Then we have screen space shadows off, then very low, then sun shadow cascades high, then sun shadows high, cache spot shadows high, and we have spot cache size low and low, low, ambient occlusion off. We have screen space reflection off. Now, this is where this gets interesting. So if anyone's having problems with the screen being blurry at all, like if you're looking on a map somewhere and it's just super, super blurry. Now, this is what Fidelity FX Cast is. So on screen right now, I'll be showing you the difference between having it on and off. I'll put it on, put side by side, so like a comparison for it. So as you can see on the screen, left side should be blurry, right side should be clear. This is with Fidelity FX Cast on. Title should be above them also, so you guys know which one is on and off. So and under quality, if you click show more, you want to turn that on, and then you want to turn the cache strength all the way up. So this makes it from being super blurry and then doing non-blurry. So I wanted to do it on a Red Star because I know Red Star is one of the worst maps for this ever. It was in the beta and it still is in the game. But yeah, so that's what Fidelity FX Cast is. We have anti-aliasing on the smallest setting, T2X. Then we have depth of field off. You always want that off. And I use my VRAM usage at 70%. Now for gameplay, we have color customization. You normally want to change the enemy color down to red. Default's orange. So I know some of y'all in my Twitch and on my YouTube want to know some of my settings that I run on my controller. So first off, we have 7.7 for both horizontal and vertical. We have 1.0 for ground and air. I don't use none of those, so I don't change it. Now this is where it gets interesting. So I have a custom sensitivity per zoom. So low zoom, I put on 0.6, then 0.7 for two times, 0.3 for three times, 0.8 for three times, my bad. Then we have 0.9 for four zoom, then 0.9 for five, and then 1.9. Now I play button layout preset, I play on flipped, then just standard, all the standard controller vibration, you want to turn that off. Weapon fire threshold, keep that on. Everything here past advanced controls is normally the same as what it was until we get down to left stick minimum input dead zone and right stick minimum input dead zone. I normally put them at five in general. I know some of my teammates put it on zero, but I normally just put them on 0.5, and then regular max input is 99 on both. Yeah guys, that's it for me. Hope you guys did enjoy the video. Hope this helps you out a little bit in terms of your graphic settings to get rid of that blur. And anyone that wanted to know my controller settings got to learn something from it, and maybe it helps them out in the long run. But yeah guys, it's been your boy Effective, aka Dallas. I'll talk to you guys later. Peace out.